Hey guys, here's a new video. Today I'm doing the first of hopefully many Adventure Times figures brought to you by Jazwares. I know it makes a lot of people kind of just shudder out of fear because apparently Jazwares isn't that great of a toy company. My experience with them is very, very limited. I think I have a couple of the Robot Chicken figures and I'm not even sure those were by Jazwares, to be honest. But this is the first of the three that I have coming to me. I have the 5-inch Jake, the 5-inch Finn, and of course the 10-inch Finn is here already. And it's ultimately not a bad toy. I'm going to say right now, it's not horrible, but unless you want to have a nicely sized Finn in your collection, I would say hold out for the 5-inch one. Just going to say it right now. This is the box he comes in. You can see you can try his faces in packaging. A lot of easier to just leave him out of packaging for the whole thing. You see a 10-inch figure with changeable faces. And there's a Finn on the top. You got Jake on the back. There's some of his faces you have. And that's really it. I mean, it's simple, but it works for the show and, it's packaging, whatever. So here we got Finn. And if you're like me, you've been scouting these toys out for a while. Amazon has had this one especially in stock for about 2 weeks. The problem is it's not through Amazon.com, it's through a seller on Amazon.com. So I thought this guy would be going for about $40 because it's a 10-inch figure. Maybe that's the standard. ToysRUs.com has him still in stock at the time of this video being made for $13. I think the retail price would be about $18, $19, but ToysRUs.com got it for $13. I would say if you are interested in getting this toy, go through them especially. Maybe try the retail store. I've not been to a Toys R Us in a while, but I guess that's the kind of one thing I like about it. It's a nicely sized figure, but it's only $13. The 5-inch, I think, Finn is $10. So $3 more, you get 5 more inches. I know, guys, we'd kill for that kind of opportunity. So here we got Finn, and the sculpt is very, very nice. He does have all of Finn's features. You will notice this is a very simple toy. There's not much articulation. The toy itself is mostly hollow, and you can really kind of see that, yeah, it's a $13 toy. The main selling point of this is, of course, the face-changing feature. All you do is give a little rub. There you go. And there you go. And there you go. And that's why I wanted this. That's the only reason I really wanted this toy, was to be able to have a large Finn displayed somewhere with any face that I wanted. It works. It's not a bad feature. Articulation-wise, the head just rotates. And that's really it. The waist rotates. Yep. The legs can go forward. And they can go back, although the joint is really, really stiff. You will have to kind of get it going, and I'm seeing some paint scraping off the joint, just from casual use. And depending on how you get the legs posed, you can get them kind of like that, kind of work out some kind of kick, but that's really it for the joints. That one's a lot looser. This one's still fairly tight, but okay. You got onto his knee. Of course, the knee can bend. He can even go forward and break that whole knee. You can rotate at the knee, and his ankles can rotate, although this one works a lot better. It's still very, very stiff, but it does rotate. Now, his arms are iffy. One feature of these toys is they've given them their stretchy limbs, as they're calling it. They're not so much stretchy. One thing in the show is whenever they're really excited, their arms will like kind of wave around. It's really hard to even show off on there, but it's kind of wave around kind of thing. So they left the arms those kind of bendy, rubbery kind of junk. Now, there is a wire going through this. I think the 5-inch figures don't have that wire, so you're stuck with them just being in a simple pose. And it kind of works, but it kind of doesn't. Now, getting his arms posed, you can do with a lot of force, and you can leave it there, but it will bend back over time. It's not going to stay that way. So most of the time, you're kind of stuck with this standard pose as it comes up packaging. This arm, you can straighten out, but it doesn't look right. It looks really weird. Rotation at the shoulders is pretty much non-existent. If you try to rotate them, you can see they're kind of linked together. And no matter how much you move them, they're not going to move. So you're pretty much stuck with just moving that around for casual play. If you want to play with your kids or yourself or your friends, whatever, you can do that. But displaying it in a kind of dynamic pose isn't going to happen. You're stuck with it basically like that. Now, on to his accessories. He does have a couple, which is a very, very little, but they are kind of nice. So he has his backpack, which I do like. It can open up, and I'm hoping at some point we'll have either a BMO to put in there, Or a Jake, maybe. There are two little pegs inside that maybe a small Jake could peg into. I would hope we get something. Otherwise, why have it open? Why? I don't know, but it's not bad. And he got a sword, which I do like. It's simple, and it works for the show. It's pretty much, I think, dead on to how it looks in the show. There is some tape residue still on it. But it looks nice. The issue with his hand being rubber is that he cannot really grip the sword. He can hold it and it kind of rests in his hand. But the second you kind of twist his arm around and move it, you're going to work the sword out. And you're kind of stuck with this kind of pose. That's really it. The backpack I do have an issue with. When I got this guy out of packaging, his paint was really perfect. Apparently there's a lot of issues with some paint problems with these quality control things. His paint was flawless. There was no issues. But doing the backpack a couple of times on and off, there's paint scraping off of his shoulders really badly. Really bad underneath his arms, too. So, I'm going to say it right now. When you get this guy, think of what look you want the most. Do you want the backpack on or off? And then stick with that decision. You can take it on and off fairly easily, but the more you do it, the more paint you're going to scrape off. And it's a cheap toy, but you want to have it looking as nice as possible. To put the backpack on, though, it's really simple, but it does take a little bit of work. I find the best bet is starting with his right arm. Just kind of work it through. And this doesn't stretch at all. If they actually made this kind of a stretchy material, it would work a whole lot better. It being the stiff plastic puts a lot of pressure on the toy and causes the paint to flake off and stuff. But anyway, get this arm that's already bent and just kind of work it around. Get it through there, and then just give a little push. It starts to get this side up all the way, and then once you get it going, there you go. Now once you get it on, it does cover some of that paint scraping a little bit. There's some there. There's a big one there that's not going to get covered up. But the backpack does look nice on him. It does make him a tad bit back heavy. He does kind of lean backwards a little bit more because of it. But once you get him in the right pose, he does look nice with the backpack. And I actually like it more with it on him. So you can kind of get his arm, check his arm a little more bent inward, maybe? So once you get his sword in place, go ahead and doopa 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 doopa. There you go. There's your Finn. It's not bad. It's not that bad of a toy, but ultimately you may want to wait for the 5-inch one. I do hope they released a 10-inch version of Jake to go with him, just kind of to complete the pair. But I really do hope they focus more on the 5-inch line, have those being their major line, and then this just being kind of a bonus thing. $13 for it isn't bad, but it's not terrible overall. It isn't. It could be a whole lot worse. It could be a whole lot better. But I do like it, and the only question now is really, where am I going to put it? I don't know. It's a large toy. But anyway, hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.